Dear friends, at the close of the day, it is always profitable, valuable to look back over our day and to identify the times we were with God, that we were doing what God would want us to do, and to identify the times we were far from God. We did things we should not have done. This practice of reviewing the day is very popular amongst the Jesuits. It is very popular amongst the Jesuits. It's a spiritual exercise promoted and developed by Saint Ignatius of Loyola. He didn't invent it, but he emphasized its value and importance. And so at the close of this day, the close of this week, I thought perhaps it might be something that we could do together. This practice is called the examine. And the purpose of it is to help us to see where God is with us and moving us. It also allows us to learn, to practice, to continually see God in the present moment. Not simply in the day that has passed, but in also the one to come. For many people, the examine is one of the easiest prayers because it is essentially a review of the day in God's presence. That's something that most people, even newcomers to prayer, feel they can do. It's also one of the most powerful prayers. And so I thought today we would look at one of the ways to pray the examine. There are different methods. There are different versions. There may be different versions, but they all include the same basic elements. Here are the steps that I think we can use this evening. The first is presence. The second step is gratitude. The third step is to review. The fourth step is sorrow. And the fifth step is grace. With that little introduction, perhaps you would like to settle yourself. Settle yourself in an attitude of prayer. Remember that you are in the presence of God. You can see Him present in the Blessed Sacrament. With all prayer, it is important for us to begin by placing ourselves in God's presence in a conscious way. Yes, we are always in the presence of God, of course. But we so easily forget that. One of the main purposes of prayer is to bring us consciously into God's presence. So let us place ourselves in God's presence here in front of the Blessed Sacrament. Perhaps we can repeat slowly, softly, or in our minds, I am in the presence of God. I am in the presence of God. Be with me, God. Be with me. Presence of God. I am in the presence of God. Be with me, God. Be with me. As we settle into God's presence, we begin our examen with an attitude of gratitude. Why? Why is this the best and most important way to start our prayer? Firstly, it combats the common tendency, the tendency so many of us have, to focus on the negative, to see the worst of our day, the worst of ourselves. With an attitude of gratitude, we're invited instead to find grace, to find God present in the negatives. The second reason for having this gratitude for the day is that it stops us from trying to solve all sorts of problems. To look at our day, and perhaps even our lives, as a series of problems that we have to solve. That's not why we are here. Instead, gratitude forces us to move away from problem solving and helps us to recognize the blessings as well as the challenges. Giving thanks reminds us of the source of our blessings and therefore our inherent reliance on God. So, let's not start by asking God to help us. Instead, let's just thank Him for who we are and what we've done. Perhaps recall one or two things from this day that you are especially grateful for. Call these things to mind. Sit with them. Savor them. Spend a moment appreciating them. Thank God for them. The third step in our prayer is the biggest step. Here we review our day from start to finish. The aim is to notice moments when God was active in our life during the past 24 hours. The main question is, how has God spoken to you through the events of this day? Looking over your day, you gain a perspective, and you're invited to see things that you might otherwise overlook, especially if it has been a sad or stressful day. So to help you, perhaps go to the morning when you woke up and slowly roll through the day. As you do so, perhaps these questions might help. Where did I experience God? Where did I see God's invitation? Whom did I love? Who showed me love? We don't have to remember every second of the day, but we should try to remember it with as much detail as we can. Don't rush. Enter into special moments. Sit with them. You may not have had time to sit with them during the day, but sit with them now. next step is to look at anything we've done that was selfish or sinful during the day. Many people feel uncomfortable about this step. Many feel that this is religion forcing us to feel guilty, unnecessarily guilty, forcing them to feel bad. But that's not true, because all of us are human and therefore imperfect. It's healthy, it's good for us to recognize our failings and sinfulness, because this helps us to grow, to increase a healthy humility, and to remind ourselves of our need for God. Yes, we need to distinguish between guilt and shame. Guilt says, I did a bad thing, and shame says, I'm a bad person. Guilt can be healthy. Shame is unhealthy. Guilt is one way that our conscience works. Eh? If I have treated someone badly, been rude to them or gossiped about them, I feel a pang of guilt. And that's my conscience speaking. So it's important to listen. It's God's voice speaking to my soul. And after we've reviewed the day, we will naturally notice some actions that we regret. We should not despair. God is encouraging us through this time of prayer to grow, to change, to be converted. This step helps us to recognize our own imperfections, flaws and sins, and especially our need for God's grace. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. The examine looks forward. And so the final step is to ask for God's help. We might ask for grace to help in a particular area that we know will be a challenge in the next 24 hours. And so we ask for God's grace to help us face tomorrow. By grace, we mean God's help, encouragement, or presence. Those are things we certainly hope for every moment of the day ahead. as our prayer time comes to a close, we recognize that the examen, this review of the day, begins with a recognition that God gives us graces, throughout the day. And it ends with a reminder of our need for God's grace, to ask for God's grace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.